Well, we obviously have a big challenge in front of us tomorrow night. But, you know, with every challenge comes a big opportunity as well. So, you know, we're going into one of the tougher environments in the country to play against one of the best teams, if not the best team in the country. So, you know, we're going to have to be at our best. And I think our guys are up for it. They're anxious about it. And, you know, it's going to be a tough 40-minute game. There's no question about it. So we just got to be locked in on what we need to do and come out ready to play. Well, it's much easier to slow a team down than it is to speed a team up. You know, a lot of teams maybe have tried to speed them up. I just don't think it's very easy to do. You know, they're very efficient at what they do on both ends of the court. I think obviously everybody talks about how good their defense is, which is rightfully so, but I think their offense gets overlooked sometimes. They're extremely efficient. They can really make you work on defense, and they don't take good shots, they take great shots, and that's why they're so good. So, you know, to be able to play at a pace like that, you have to be great on both ends of the court, and that's what they certainly are.
These games have been ugly, the times when you played, except for the first half of the game there last year. You all seem to – what did you do different in that half than you all had done?
Well, we defended well in that half. Obviously, we had some success scoring the ball. We made some – perimeter shots, which is something you have to do. I mean, they're just not going to let you score at the rim very much. And so you have to be able to make some shots. They make you take very tough shots. And if you can make some of them, then you can score a little bit more. But, you know, they're extremely physical. They make you work on everything. And they try to kind of wear you down and beat you up a little bit. And, you know, that's just the way they've always been, no matter who their personnel is. And that's why they're successful, because they just get into you without fouling. They do an unbelievable job of defending the way they do without fouling. And it really is remarkable to watch. But, you know, we just have to stick to our game plan. And you know, we really have to focus on trying to match their intensity as far as the defensive end goes. You know, we really need to try to be as good on defense as they are. And you know, whether or not that makes it a 38-37 game, I don't know. But, you know, you have to try to be as good as they are on defense, because they're such a good offensive team.
Follow up what was asked earlier about pace, David. Do you then have to, do you go into the game just resigned that you're going to just have to beat them at their game, because it is harder to, I don't know anybody that's speeding them up?
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's, you know, Duke only scores 50-something against them, and Duke's averaging, I think, 90 points a game on the season in their own gym. So, you know, you got to know it's going to be a street fight going in there. You just have to. There's going to be spells of adversity and offensive droughts, and you just have to accept that, but you got to be able to play through it. That's the thing. You know, you got to know going in there's going to be a 5-6 minute stretch where you're not going to score, or you're going to score very little. You can't let it affect you on the other end. You have to just dig in and say, we got to take this one possession at a time. We got to focus on trying to get stops and see where it goes. But, you know, it's just the reason they've been so effective is because they get everybody to play at their pace, and they're very, very good at it.
David, this year, a lot of questions going in on how good they really would be. You know, they weren't picked in the top 2 or 3, but is this the best one you've seen, the best team of theirs you've seen?
It'd be hard not to make a case for it. I mean, they go into Duke, who's probably the most talented team in the country, and win the game. I mean, that's pretty remarkable. And, you know, they've had some unbelievable teams there, whether it's Malcolm Brogdon or Parentes or Justin Anderson or Joe Harris, those guys. I mean, they've had some big-time players and big-time teams there. And, you know, it's – I thought I saw somewhere the other day they've never actually reached number one in the country, but they've been number two a couple of times. But, you know, I don't think it – I don't know if you could pick one team – this year that's better than their team 2 or 3 years ago. You know, I think they're what they are every single year, and that's a heck of a basketball team. So, you know, you just got to give Tony all the credit in the world for whoever he brings in. They're going to do the same thing, and they do it to perfection. And it's, you know, you got to give him a lot of respect for what he's able to accomplish year in and year out.
So, David, how much do you tell your players they got to be patient, that they got to trust what the game plan is, and patience is key?
Oh, there's no question. And I think our older guys know that. They've been through it enough now. You know, Q's played against them for, this will be his fourth year, and Onis and, you know, Dang and Ray played against them. So, you know, they know what kind of game it's going to be like, and you have to accept that going in, but nonetheless, you got to come out on the court tomorrow night, and you got to execute. You got to come out and just know it's going to be a fight. I mean, there's not a whole lot else to say. It's going to be a physical, tough, tight basketball game, and if you can match their level of physicality, you at least put yourself in a position to have a chance to win the game.
This year than last?
You know, I think their offense is a little bit different this year. I think, you know, the improvement Hall has made, especially with his jump shot on the perimeter over the last couple of years, has been incredible to watch. But, you know, obviously everybody knows Kyle Guy's ability to shoot the ball and score. And, you know, Ty Jerome, even though he's only a sophomore, plays like he's a senior. You know, he's very composed. They don't turn the ball over, I think only 9 turnovers a game, which is pretty incredible. So, I think they're – I don't want to say their teams in the past haven't been good offensively, but this team this year just can really score. They're very efficient. They can shoot the ball. They can throw it inside. And, they're the definition of a team. They're playing very well together. Their bench knows their role, and they just do what they're supposed to do, and it's led them to a 20-1 record. Yeah, I mean, VJ's been playing very well the last month and a half of the season, I think. I mean, he's, you know, the other day he played really, really well. He was aggressive. He made some shots and those kinds of things. And he just is playing with confidence. He's getting better and progressing how you would expect from a sophomore at this point in his career. And, he needs to keep it going. So it's been good to see him and see his confidence in playing at a high level. Yeah, well, when we talked about it with Coach G and Vinny, you have to move your timeout as close to half court as possible because their band, which is incredible, by the way, is right there in the end zone. I mean, it's literally, if I'm the last guy on the bench, the guy playing the trumpet is right here. So, I mean, you have to move. And most of the time in the timeouts, you can't hear because they're playing. But it's a great atmosphere. You know, we've obviously haven't played very well there, but, I mean, who has? You know, it's just their fans really have bought into the style of play that they put on the floor every night. And it just goes to show, you know, their fans aren't concerned about style. They're just concerned about winning, and they've done that a lot, and their fans really appreciate it.
You mentioned Kyle. He's been really such a nice streak lately, kind of described as an outside shooter, but this year he's kind of shown he's not afraid to go to the hole as well. And somebody's playing so well, kind of streaky. Is there something that you can do to focus on and try and slow them down?
Well, I mean, as good as they are as a team on defense, they're just as good as a team on offense. They know how to play together. They all know how to play basketball. They pass the ball really well. And like I said, they're not going to come down and take a shot with 23 seconds on the shot clock unless they're just wide open for some reason. I mean, they make you work for 30 seconds. And, you almost have to – where they're really effective and dangerous, in my opinion, is the first 15 seconds of the shot clock – you know, they'll stay patient. The last 15 is where they're most dangerous, and that's when defenses usually tend to relax. You almost have to treat it as you can be a little bit more relaxed maybe the first 15 seconds, but the last 15 seconds is when you have to dig in even more because that's when they're at their best. And you know, it's whether it's Kyle coming off those screens or Jerome who can shoot the ball from 26 feet without any fear. I mean, those guys just, they really have a confidence about them that's impressive to watch.
Is it a frustrating style of ball to play against?
Yeah, it is because, you know, majority of teams in the country these days play fast. You know, they want to score, they want to get up and down, and this team's not like that. And they make you work. They really, really do. And that's why, you know, going in from a mental standpoint, if you know that's what kind of game it's going to be like, that can at least help you to where you go in one of those droughts like I talked about where you don't score for 6 minutes. And you know, it's very easy to get frustrated against them, but you just got to stay patient. You just got to stick with what the game plan is and just try to execute it as best you can.
I think you're referring to the way they play ball screens, that you've tried to play against them the same way the last 2 or 3 years, not been successful, time for a change. Do you have to change the way you play them, do something different than you've done against them?
Well, I mean, you can look at doing just things differently, but, you know, it doesn't matter if you take a team that runs a lot of ball screens, if you take a team that doesn't run any ball screens, I mean, it's just – yes, have we struggled against them? Of course we have. But name me a team that consistently has beat them over the last 5, 6 years. There isn't one. So there's not a blueprint that you can just look and say, okay, this team has beat them every game the last 4 or 5 years because it hasn't happened. So, you know, you gotta just try to match their intensity and their physicality and just attack them as much as you can. And, you don't want to just come into this game and say, okay, we're going to throw out everything we've done on offense the whole season because you don't want to do that. And so you got to just stay patient and have that mindset. You just got to be in attack mode for 40 minutes.
What is the best way for your big guys to approach that? I know they blitz the entry pass pretty quickly. What's the best way for you guys to kind of combat that?
Well, I mean, you know, teams that have had mild success against them, it's it's kind of how they play on offense. You got to stay patient. You got to move the basketball. You got to get the defense to shift, and then see if you can get it to break down a little bit towards the end of the clock. Now, you know, because you're playing into their hands. If you come down, you come off one ball screen, make one pass, and then you shoot a contested three. I mean, that just plays right into their hands. And so, you got to try to make them work. Obviously, they're coached and disciplined enough on defense to where that's what they know they have to do. But you know, you got to just try to go at them and expose them as best you can. And it's much, much easier said than done. But you know, no matter how your offense is going, like I said, you just got to focus on the other end of the court and try to you know, frustrate them on defense, I guess, as much as they do to you.
How would you describe the pack, the so-called pack line defense they use? How would you sum that up?
Well, I mean, I don't know specific details about what the premise of it is. I mean, I would think that the main premise is keeping the ball out of the lane. They all work in sync. All five guys are always covering for each other. They want to keep the ball out of, you know, the paint. But if you drew a half arc inside the three-point line at about 16 feet, they want to try to keep the ball out of that area. And they do obviously an excellent job of that. But what they do as well as anybody in the country is, if you pass to the perimeter after a couple movements and you think you have a shot, they do an unbelievable job of challenging the shot. You know, they block more jump shots than probably any team in the country, which you don't see that very often. But, you know, it's predicated on keeping the ball out of the lane and making you score from the perimeter on tough shots.
Do you feel like with your team, you had Ryan out at the beginning of the year, now, you know, with, 10 games left, the roles are kind of defined. It's just a matter of fine-tuning. People have accepted what their roles are.
Yeah, I think so. You know, our bench, I think guys know what they need to do when they come in, and I think the other day against Wake, they did that very, very well. I think, I think all of our guys just seem to be in a good rhythm right now, whether it's playing with certain guys or you know, those kinds of things rotation-wise, and everybody just kind of knows what they need to do. They know what we're trying to do as a team, and you know, we seem to be getting better as the season goes on, which is what you want. And, you know, it's the thing that just pleases me more than anything about this team is how much they enjoy seeing each other succeed. I mean, that play the other day when I think VJ scored and you know, we got a turnover in the press, VJ got a steal and then did that three. I mean, the enthusiasm you see is just incredible. And it's really, really awesome. And it's why I enjoy coming to work every day and coaching these guys, because they really enjoy pulling for each other.
How rare is that?
It can be, yeah. I mean, but I said it since day one at the beginning of this season. I knew from the first day school started that we had a unique group in that regard. They all got along really well. We didn't have anybody who was concerned about their own individual agenda. The winning was the most important thing to them. And, you know, it really has been great. And I think, you know, I think it started a couple years ago when Damian and Trey were here. I think they kind of changed the culture a little bit to where it wasn't about individuals, it was about the team. And I think that rubbed off on Q and Honest and Dang and Ray when they were younger and they saw that. And now they're kind of passing it on to these younger guys. So it's been really good to see, and it's been a lot of fun to coach.
You can say you have confidence in Darius shooting, and he says he has confidence. But, I mean, what does it do for him to actually see the ball go through the basket?
Yeah, that helps. I mean, especially your first one, you come in and – what he's learned along with Malik and Jordan is, and it's a tough thing to learn as a freshman, is in high school, as soon as you catch the ball, if you think you're open, you're allowed to shoot it. And in college, it just doesn't work that way. And it's not like they're necessarily bad shots, but you want to take shots in the rhythm of the offense. You know, we're not a team that's trying to score 120 and we're just going to come down and jack up shots. I mean, we want to take good quality shots. And you know, these guys have been shooting a better percentage because they've been doing that. And so that's a good sign of them learning, paying attention and listening. And you know, they're starting to see that, you know, maybe what I'm telling them is starting to work, which is also good too.
How do you balance kind of hammering home that they really have to be very prepared for Virginia without getting into their heads that they're 1-5 since joining the ACC against Virginia? And a lot of those games have not really been close.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we're treating this as a road game against a team that is really good this season, and it's a big opportunity for us. You know, they're a different team than they were last year and the year before that, and so are we. So, you know, we're not going to look into the past. We're just looking at this game. You know, it wouldn't matter if we were playing at, you know, Duke tomorrow or anything. I mean, it's a tough, tough road game in the toughest conference in the country. So you just got to – that's how you got to approach it. You just look, okay, what do we do? We haven't changed anything from a routine standpoint. We watch our film, we come out and practice, we feel like we do what we feel like we need to do to try to have a chance to win, and we'll get on the plane tonight and go play. And that's just the way we've approached it. We're not going to, you know, for lack of a better cliche, we're not going to try to lose our minds over this game just because, you know, they've been really, really good the last couple of years. We're just going to approach it as we see fit and come out and play as hard as we can and compete for 40 minutes. Is Anas coming in here after me?
No, we can bring him.
I'm going to be out on the court with him at 2:30. We're going to play one-on-one, so we'll get a video copy and send it to you, okay? No, I'm just kidding. No, I mean, Anas is...
Did you see the horse game? The...
Yeah, oh, that's right. Yeah, I don't know if anybody saw that. We played horse in December, and we got a video of it, so maybe Kenny will circulate that. But, you know, I'll just leave it at that, so... And everybody seemed to be surprised. Oh, man, you could shoot? Just because I didn't shoot in college didn't mean that I couldn't shoot. There's a big difference, so. Yeah, but you got to know where your bread is buttered, so.
Unedited.
All right, thank you guys.